Hi, welcome to Magical Main Street Dads. I'm Josh.
I'm Nevin.
And this episode, we're going to continue our quest for food at Magic Kingdom. Because, like we've always been talking about, when we talked about the parks, is the big part of it is the food. As much as the attractions, it's fueling yourself and giving yourself the energy and trying new things. So last week, we did the sit-down meals, our top three sit-down places to go. And we had some agreements there. So this time, we're going to do the quick service meals. Places to go to spend your quick service credit, or if you're buying your own food and don't have a meal plan, this is a great opportunity to not spend so much and still get a decent meal at any of the parks. But like I said, we're going to focus on Magic Kingdom. So three places. We each got our three. And we'll count down from least favorite to favorite. But still, the least favorite is still one of our favorites. So, yeah. So Nevin, what do you have for your number three?
Okay.
I'm curious and excited.
Well, my number three, of course, you have to bank left to Adventureland.
Ah, yes.
We are off to Aloha Isle. Gotta get me some Dole Whip. The Aloha Isle, you can get all types of nice snacks there. They're considered snacks, but they're actually meals. The pineapple upside down Dole Whip cake is there, and literally both my grandkids can share that on one snack credit. So value wise, it's great value for what you're doing. A lot of the quick services that I go to, it's all about value. Am I getting the most out of my meal plan and things like that? So Aloha Isle, great, quick. They also have like some soft serve where it's orange with vanilla. Great, especially for when you go, Josh, during the hot months. Quick, refreshing. It's not heavy on you. You're right there in Adventureland, so you can go to Liberty Square. You can go to Jungle Cruise, Pirates. You're actually in a good spot to go to different rides as well. But definitely Aloha Isle. My biggest drawback is there's not much seating there. So if you want to sit down and eat the stuff, you might not want to go to Aloha Isle. But other than that, value is great. There's not really much lines because it's really quick in and out type thing. Just lack of seating for me.
Yeah. I think when I get my Dole Whip when I'm there, I'm on the run eating that.
Yeah.
Because it's just so refreshing and you're just – brain freeze, everything. that to me is something that I get and go.
Yeah.
I'm on the run. So at that point, I'm actually headed probably back over to Tomorrowland. So by the time I get there, that thing's gone. And I'm ready to hit a ride over there. So Aloha Isle for you.
That's number three. Aloha Isle.
All right. So my number three is at the end of Main Street, as you're going left, on the corner is everybody's favorite hot dog joint, Casey's Corner. Casey's Corner is awesome. I love it. Talk about value. If you're using your quick service meal credit, try to find something that's $13.99 to. Okay. I think it goes up to like $14.99. Try to find some place that has that higher value. This place has the footlong hot dogs. And my favorite is the chili cheese footlong. You get fries with it. Mm-hmm. It's $13.50 now. And I mean, it's a footlong hot dog with chili and cheese on it, man. It's like, it's Americana right there. You think about the ballpark and chili cheese dogs. It's awesome. The other thing I like there are the mini corn dog nuggets.
Okay.
Oh, you get like this huge thing of them. I mean, it fits in two hands, fries, and you just sit there and just chow down. It comes with cheese sauce. Either one of those, pretty good bang for your buck. You're going to be full. Okay. Now, if you're not into the foot-long hot dog for $1.50 less, you can go for like more of a regular size bun length hot dog. But heck, for another $1.50, upgrade.
Yeah.
If you don't eat that last bite, who cares?
The Disney ducks will have it.
Yeah, exactly. Cons there are the seating. It is a very busy place. It's quick though. I've never waited super long there. I mean, sometimes, the line does get pretty long, but it does move pretty quick. You could be standing eating your hot dog, but there's places to sit. You can sit on some like little walls that are around there. You're right near the Crystal Palace. There are some tables outside. Again, if you get there around parade time, you're probably not going to get a seat. But if you get there a little bit earlier, get your meal and you kind of stay there, then you got a seat. So that is my number three.
Not bad, Casey Corner. Good pick.
All right, what's your number two?
Number two. Okay. I am going to be going to Fantasyland.
Okay.
Going to Friar Nooks. You
Okay.
must hit Friar Nooks when it's almost time for a little break to recharge the batteries. Friar Nooks, it's quick service. They have the tater tot bowls, where they load up the tater tots with like buffalo chicken, chili cheese, all types of stuff. Or if it's really hot, you want to do it, they have sundaes, milkshakes, and things like that. That stuff is snack credit wise. And in the other episodes, I've said my grandkids would split a hot fudge sundae. That's how big it was, enough for both of them to enjoy it. So, at Friar Nooks, you got a little bit of both. You can get quick service as far as the tater tot bowls, which are very good, by the way. Or you can go snack wise. And then what we would do is go back into the by Pete's Sideshow area, that little area to charge our phones, sit down, let the kids go play in Casey June's Junior Waterloo Park thing there. And we would eat our ice cream and just chill in the back in the air conditioning and recharge our batteries and then go for the rest of the day. Con wise, there is zero seating.
Yeah, no,
There's not
no.
even, you gotta leave that area to go get a seat. There is no seating.
And when you get your food, watch out for the dropped ice cream cones.
Yes, Josh
They're
will laugh at you.
like ice cream landmines, I call them. I always feel bad for that kid that's crying, like the ice cream cone.
Yeah, he feels bad, ladies and gentlemen, while he's licking the ice cream, looking at
Sorry.
the kid. Yeah. Mine didn't drop.
I also know to hold it with two hands.
True. That's how big the ice cream cones are, ladies and gentlemen. A grown man has to hold it with two hands.
Yeah.
That's why when I ever got it for the grandkids, I asked for a bowl. Just took the cone right into the bowl.
Good tip. Extra tip right there. Excellent. Excellent. Very nice. Very nice. I had a feeling you were going to go there
Yeah.
for one of them. For one of them.
For one of them. Yeah.
Okay. Mine, I talked about when we talked about Magic Kingdom as a whole, was, and I just found it the last time I was there. And I was like, let's try it. This is Pecos Bill. And we talked about it a little bit in depth. They have the secret menu nacho item that you talked about, Nev, and I didn't do that. So,
You weren't that adventurous.
yeah, me, the kid, and my mom was a vegetarian. That really wouldn't have worked well for $100. So, no. But what I liked, again, I think a lot of the quick service meal places, they're so efficient. You don't wait super long. You really don't. And this place has, what I like about it is it's spread out inside. They have multiple counters working and going. And the best thing is the Fixin's Bar, where you can pile on all your stuff. So we're talking like tacos, nachos type, you know, Tex-Mex, Mexican kind of food. So load everything up, the guacamole, sour cream, salsa. Heck, you can make a meal out of that and go up for more. Don't be shy. And it is a pretty good deal overall, I think. You get a lot of food plus that extra things you can put on top. I think it's a really great deal. It is super busy where you go to sit. So seating, I think I did have to walk around a little bit, and then you're like, okay, there's a seat. What I did like is that I think there's outdoor seating and indoor. It's open air, but you're still inside. You are shaded at parts. So very well done. I just really dug it, and I will go back there again.
And if you time it right and go to that open air seating, the parade goes right by there.
Yes.
They also have the Country Bear Jamboree characters come out and they do like a little hoedown show. So if you can time it right, use your My Disney Experience app. You can time it right. You can sit down, eat, and watch a show.
It's the best of both worlds.
That's right.
So that was number two. We're cruising through these.
Yeah, we are. I'm just getting hungry, though.
Yeah, I know. I'm like, oh, I didn't eat enough earlier. So the number one spot, Nevin, and we think we...
Yeah, this is a guarantee. We know it.
We know. Maybe you guys know as well, if you paid attention in our Magic Kingdom preview show a couple weeks back. Nev, what's
the week show?
Yeah. What's number one?
Number one is without a doubt at Liberty Tree Square. Or I'm sorry, Liberty Square. I'm thinking Liberty Tree Tavern there a minute. Liberty Square. We are off to Columbia Harbor House.
Very nice.
Yeah. This is quick service, not snack oriented like my other picks. This is legit quick service. But the food is very light. It's based in a New England setting where you're going to have your lobster crab sandwiches and things like that. Seating is not a problem like many other locations. Like I said in the other episode, there's a second floor. A lot of people don't know it. What we did, mobile ordering was just starting when we were down there. We did it on the app. My daughter went upstairs with my grandkids to get seats. I went to the line, got the food, went upstairs. No wait. It was air conditioned. I really don't have anything negative on Columbia Harbor House. I really don't.
You love Columbia Harbor House.
Oh, don't you? I do.
You go there every time. Every time you do.
Yeah. Yeah, it's hard to beat that speaking from value for your meal plan. Okay, the lobster crab seafood sandwich that I normally get, it's like a seafood salad. So it's not like heavy lobster meat and all this stuff. It's a light seafood salad. You get either potato chips or french fries. And it's like $22 for this sandwich, but it's a lunch credit. So you're definitely getting the value out of your meal plan.
I think so at this place. I really do. That's my number one as well, man.
And great
points. Yeah. I like that we agree on so much.
Yeah.
You know, but it goes to show when people really like something and word of mouth gets out too.
Yeah.
I mean, I think people who go there, they're like, ooh. Why didn't I go there before?
Right.
And I've been there three times or so, four times. I just keep going.
Yeah.
Like what I spent, like I do 2 days at the park, one day at least I'm going there. think 1 year I went twice.
Yeah.
And it was just like, because you walk around and you're like, oh, maybe I'll try that. We're nostalgic people, us Disney fans. So we like the comfort. And Columbia House is comfort for me.
Great.
I like the fried platters that they have. And again, you're like, oh, fried food on a hot day. But the thing is, this place is, it's loud downstairs, I think, because you have the kitchen and everything there. But when you get upstairs and people go upstairs, it's pretty mellow. And you're not rushed at all. I like to get the food, go upstairs, pile on my malt vinegar onto my fried food. And the fried platters, there's a trio platter that I like to get. Fried shrimp, chicken breast, and battered fish, fries. I mean, it's like fried food overload. Your arteries are like, ah. But get a nice iced tea with it. Man, oh, it just, at about 12:30, 1 o'clock in the afternoon, I think usually hit about 1, it's like perfect time of day.
Yeah.
And then if you have your dinner reservation for more like a 6 o'clock-ish, you have plenty of time to digest. It's a place where you could spend 30 minutes easy eating, relaxing. Take advantage to relax in this place.
Yep.
Like Pecos Bill, you can't relax there. It's like there you kind of do – let me put another con on Pecos Bill. You kind of feel like you have to eat quick to get out.
Right.
Because it's so busy. This place, when you're upstairs, it's just like another world. Yeah. And the decor is really cool. Yeah. You do feel like you're in New England. The cast members that come and clean up the tables and wipe everything down, they're all dressed in New England turn of whatever century, clothes. It's really neat. I have nothing bad to say about it either, man. It's great value. You're talking about like $14 and up, and it's a lunch credit, a quick service credit. Fantastic,
yeah.
Deals. And it's something that kids can find something.
Oh, God, so, yeah.
I mean, kids love fish sticks and breaded fish, French fries, breaded shrimp, chicken nuggets. And these aren't chicken nuggets. They're like chicken chunks that are breaded. So there's not Mickey D's chicken nuggets, beaks and claws in it. it's the real deal. And I always feel like, it is real food when I go there.
God, yeah, it's fresh. Yeah. Another thing I just thought of, if you think about it, Columbia Harbor House is almost like a hybrid sit-down restaurant. Because you said it, you're perfect. When you're on that second floor, you're not rushed at all. That's why I always try timing it, because there's a little walkway where you can go sit there. You literally, the parade goes right by you. You could sit there for, let's say you get there 20 minutes before the parade. You could sit there 20 minutes before the parade and 20 minutes after the parade, and nobody will say, we need this table.
Yeah, so I've never
had that issue. Yeah.
No, not at all. Not at all. Now, I was just thinking about with these quick service places, you go and get your food at a counter. You order, or you mobile order, and you have to go and get a table. If there's more than one person in your party, I know some people separate. One person's like, well, I'm going to go here for lunch. You go there. We'll meet up afterwards. But if you have at least one other person, send that person to go get the table. Take their order. Hey, what do you want? Let them go get the table. We all have cell phones. Get on the horn. Where are you? And it cuts down on the time. And it cuts down on the line, people.
Yes.
That's an important thing. So the line isn't as long. Let your family or party go get the table. Yes. Hey, I'm upstairs. No, have that person call you. Hey, I'm upstairs. Go to the back stairs right up there. We'll be waving for you when you come by.
Hey, you know what? It's not that big upstairs to where you need to call.
I know.
Oh, there's Josh right over there.
That is so true.
That's why, like I said, mobile ordering just started when we were down there. I said, you know what? We'll do the order on the app. I sent Jade and the kids upstairs, and we got there. I think I waited maybe 5 minutes to get my order, and then went and sat down right away.
Yeah. I mean, I talked about the efficiency of the quick service places. The turnover is so quick. They just keep making this food. So it's made to order, but the turnover is so quick that it's still fresh. You're not eating fried shrimp and, you know, French fries been sitting around under a heat lamp for 30 minutes.
No, this ain't McDonald's quick service.
Yeah, no, no. And that's anywhere. That's why it's so efficient.
Yeah. Yeah. The food is fresh. Matter of fact, if memory serves me correct, they make the bread right there as well. They don't bring it in. They make the bread. Or at the Boardwalk Bakery, they make the bread. So I forget exactly where. But everything is made on site. The sandwiches are made to order. So as soon as your order comes in, a cast member is making it for you. Yeah, I just love Columbia Harbor House. Always had, even as a kid. Like you said, kids will enjoy the menu. My grandkids were getting shrimp all the time. So.
And what I like about this place, too, or I could probably talk about this place for another hour.
probably.
We won't do that to you. But the sides, you could get vegetables, rice. You don't have to get French fries.
No.
And that's what I really like about it, too. Like, you get a salmon platter. It comes with rice and vegetables. So you don't have to get the French fries. So there are some healthier alternatives that you can get there. They have salads. So there are things a little lighter. You don't have to go with the fried stuff. But every time I do, I mean, I'm guilty. So,
yeah.
But it's vacation time, and I got to have it there.
That's like right.
Sense. It's a very comfortable place. I like it. I dig it. I dig it. I love it. I love it. We agreed on number one.
Which we knew we were.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. We were prepping for this. And he's like, well, we know what number one's going to be for both of us.
And the thing is, even before Josh and I were doing these videos, when we were first talking about Disney, is we both knew Columbia Harbor House right off the bat. So.
Yeah, absolutely. Absolutely. No, I think we both had some really good top threes there, man.
Yeah.
Very nice. Very nice. Try to think what else I got to add here. Just get the most for your credit.
God, yeah.
Especially with the quick service. Okay, that's, we talked about saving money. We're saving money, like on our first episodes, saving. This is why. So you take advantage of everything. So
exactly. It's all about using your credits. If you're on the meal plan, it's all about using your credits wisely to get the biggest bang for your buck.
Right.
Don't waste a credit on a $4 item just because you want that cheeseburger. Go to a good place, and here's a $15 plate that I can use my quick service credit. That's getting the best bang for your buck right there.
Absolutely. And if you're not on the meal plan, these quick service places are excellent to go to.
Oh, God, yeah.
Don't want to spend the over $100 for a family of four to sit down and have a meal. These are still quality food.
Yeah.
It's quality food that you're getting, and a lot.
Yeah.
So you won't be disappointed.
No. And another thing is, if you're, let's just say you're only there for 2-3 days. Do you really want to do a sit down meal where you're spending maybe an hour at a restaurant? Or do you want to just go in there? Hey, we're at Magic Kingdom just one day. Let's just, you know, get some food and go.
That's an excellent point. Excellent point. Excellent. So I think that's it for me on the top three quick service meal places to go to at Magic Kingdom. So I think that's it.
That's it.
All right. Well, thank you, everybody, for continuing to watch the videos. We appreciate it very, very much. You can reach out to us anytime through any of the social media. Just search Magical Main Street Dads on Facebook and Instagram. We're there. Twitter, Magical Main ST Dads. And we have email, magicalmainstreetdads@gmail.com. Check out the YouTube video channel, Magical Main Street Dads, because this is where you're watching this. Tell your friends. Spread the word. We're trying to give you some really good tips here to make your visit to any one of these parks at Walt Disney World that much more special. So that's our goal. And they give you these little tips here and there. We're talking a lot about food right now, but we had little tips in here for you to pay attention to.
Ice cream cone bowl.
Yes. Yes. Parade spots. Don't forget that.
Air conditioned parade spots, because you know, dads, we hate hot and humid.
Yes, especially us Wookiee dads. So, so hit the bell on everything. Subscribe, like our Facebook page, interact with us. If you have an idea for a video that you want to see, if you have questions, shoot us the email. Check, direct message us on Twitter, on Instagram. We're there. We want to hear from you. Yep. So reach out to us.
Yeah, all this right. Series we're doing came from one of our subscribers. So yep. We definitely take the feedback and run with it, guys.
Yep. And let us know, what's your top three? What's your top three quick service places at Magic Kingdom? Do you agree with us? Do you have one that you want us to try? Let us know. We're all ears.
I tell you what, to get me to go from Columbia Harbor House, that quick service better be a five diamond restaurant.
Well, maybe on the other day that you're there. You don't want to do two days.
I always do 2 days at Magic Kingdom. I always do two.
All right. Well, with that, I think we're out. Thanks again for all your support. We appreciate it. And until next time, see ya.
Thanks. Have a good one.
Thank you.